Welcome once again, everyone, to this week's Race to IAS Current Affairs Guru. I hope everybody is doing great. Let's look at some of the important current events that happened between 8th and 15th April. So the first one is regarding the COVID-19 Students Helpline Portal, launched jointly by All India Council for Technical Education, or AICTE, and Ministry of Human Resource and Development. Due to the lockdown prevailing in the country and the closure of colleges and hostels as a result, many students are now in need of accommodation, food, or online classes, transportations, etc. This portal aims to connect those who are willing to provide help with those who need help. Next is regarding the online cultural competition named Mo Pratibha, launched by Odisha. Pratibha means talent in Odia. So what is this competition all about? It will enable children to participate in various activities such as painting, writing of slogans, short stories, poems, etc. on the following themes such as being at home during lockdown and my responsibility as a young citizen during COVID-19. It aims to keep children engaged at home during the lockdown period and is implemented in collaboration with UNICEF. So next news item is regarding National Maritime Day. India observes National Maritime Day on 5th April every year. And what is the purpose of National Maritime Day? It is to illustrate the relevance of supporting intercontinental commerce for the advancement of global economy. National Maritime Day 2020 was the 57th edition of the National Maritime Day. Next news item is regarding Operation Sanjeevani. All of you might know what Sanjeevani is from the story of Hanuman in Ramayana, right? When Lakshmana was wounded, Hanuman lifted up a whole mountain containing the medicinal herb Sanjeevani and saved Lakshmana's life. Likewise, through Operation Sanjeevani, Indian Air Force is airlifting 6.2 tons of essential medical supplies to the Maldives as an assistance in the fight against the COVID-19. The medicines procured from various cities were delivered by a Hercules aircraft of Indian Air Force. Next, an initiative named Karuna has been launched by the Civil Services Officers Association to support and supplement the government's efforts in fighting coronavirus. It stands for Civil Services Association's Reach to Support in Natural Disasters. And as per the initiative, the offices have set up teams in sync with the 11 empowered groups created by the Modi government to tackle all issues related to the COVID-19 outbreak. Next is regarding an advisory issued by National Tiger Conservation Authority, NTCA, and Central Zoo Authority, CZA. Under this advisory, the bodies advised alert to the chief wildlife warden of the Madhya Pradesh and all other states because it was reported that a captive tiger in US exhibited symptoms of COVID-19 infection. It is now suspected that the death of a tiger in Pench Tiger Reserve of Madhya Pradesh with severe lung infection and respiratory problems on April 5 was due to COVID-19 infection. This slide shows the details regarding Pench Tiger Reserve. Those who want can pause the video and read. The next news item says that the Union Cabinet has reduced the salaries of MPs by 30% for a year. And the Local Area Development Fund of the MPs, that is MP LAD scheme, has been suspended for 2 years. The amount served thus can go to the Consolidated Fund of India to fight COVID-19. The minister also announced that the president, vice president, the governors of states also have voluntarily decided to take a pay cut as a social responsibility. This money also will go to the Consolidated Fund of India. The next slide provides the details of MP LAD scheme. It is an ongoing central sector scheme which was launched in 1993-94. Central sector scheme means this scheme is entirely funded by the central government and not the state government. So what does this scheme do? It provides the members of parliament to initiate the construction of durable community assets based on locally felt needs in their constituencies, like drinking water, education, public health, sanitation, roads, etc. And it is being implemented by the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation. Some additional features are given in this slide. Those who want can pause and read it. So the next is regarding the World Health Day. The World Health Day is a global health awareness day which is being celebrated on 7th of April every year. And what is the theme of World Health Day this year? It is support nurses and midwives. Also, the WHO has named the year 2020 as the International Year of the Nurses and Midwife. The next is regarding NASA's Artemis base camp on Moon. NASA has unveiled its plans to set up the first human base camp called Artemis on Moon's South Pole by year 2024. Now, the aim of NASA's Artemis program is to land humans on the Moon by 2024, like it did in 1969. So the next is an initiative called Lifeline Udaan, launched by Ministry of Civil Aviation to help India fight against COVID-19. What does this initiative do? It transports medical cargo. Under this initiative, 132 cargo flights have been operated so far across the country to transport medical cargo, including remote and hilly areas. Medical supplies of more than 184 tons have been delivered till date during lockdown period with the support of Air India, Alliance Air, Indian Air Force and private airlines. Next news item says that India lifts ban on export of hydroxychloroquine and paracetamol, which are key medications to battling the COVID-19 infection. Hydroxychloroquine is a drug which is used to treat malaria, and scientists are not 100% sure about the efficacy of using it for the treatment of COVID-19. But its usage has been proved to be effective in a number of cases by now, and many countries, including India, is using it in treatment regimen for COVID-19. This slide provides some more information regarding hydroxychloroquine. Those who want can pause it and read. So next is regarding Delhi's 5T war against coronavirus. It was devised by the Delhi government and was announced by the Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal. So what are the 5 T's of this strategy? They are testing, tracing, treatment, teamwork, and tracking and monitoring. So the first T is testing, which when being done on a mass scale, enables the actual data of people affected by novel coronavirus. The second T is tracing, which involves identifying and quarantining people who have come in contact with infected persons. The third component is treatment. The fourth element is teamwork, and collective efforts are being made to fight the virus. The fifth T is tracking and monitoring. Next news item is regarding the Samadhan Online Challenge by Ministry of Human Resources and Development. This challenge is open to student and innovators, researchers, educators, and startups to participate, where you can pitch in your own creative solutions to the challenges faced during COVID-19 pandemic, like shortage of personal protection equipment, observation of quarantine, etc. The last date of applications was April 14. Next is regarding DigiLocker Digital Repository. So what is DigiLocker? It is an Aadhaar-based, cloud-based locker in which users can store electronic versions of important documents like birth certificates, voter ID cards, university documents, PAN cards, etc. Now, DigiLocker has been designated as the sole National Academic Depository, or NAD, by the Ministry of Human Resources and Development, essentially allowing educational institutions under the ministry to store digital copies of academic awards, mark sheets, and certificates on the cloud-based service. This slide provides all the details regarding DigiLocker. Those who need can pause and read. Next is regarding the Wisden Leading Cricketer in the World title. So what is Wisden? All of you might have heard. It's a cricket reference book published annually in the United Kingdom and is also called the Bible of Cricket. So Wisden has selected Ben Stokes as the leading cricketer in the world this year. He has entered Virat Kohli's 3-year reign as Wisden's leading cricketer in the world after playing a starring role in England's World Cup win last year. He is currently the vice captain of the England Test team. He is also the first England player to receive the honour since Andrew Flintoff in 2005, and had won the ICC Player of the Year award too. So, Wisden has also selected Ellis Perry of Australia as the leading women cricketer in the world this year, and she has replaced Smriti Mandhana of India. Next news item speaks about iGOAT, which is an e-learning platform launched by Government of India to combat COVID-19. The platform offers 9 courses on topics like basics of COVID-19, ICU care and ventilation management, clinical management, infection prevention through PPE, infection control and prevention, quarantine and isolation, laboratory sample collection and testing, management of COVID-19 cases, COVID-19 training. Next is regarding the Forbes billionaires list called the richest in 2020, and it is topped by Jeff Bezos, who is the CEO of Amazon. He was followed by Bill Gates at the second position. The third position was grabbed by Bernard Arnault, the chairman and CEO of luxury fashion brand LVMH, or popularly known as Louis Vuitton. Next is regarding the convalescent plasma therapy. So scientists are conducting the efficacy of this method to fight against the coronavirus. What does this therapy do? It involves transfusing certain components from the blood of people who have had the COVID-19 virus and recovered into people who are very sick with the virus or people who are at high risk of getting the virus. So once a person has had the virus and recovered, that person has developed antibodies that will stay in their blood waiting to fight the same virus should it return. These antibodies, when injected into another person with the disease, recognizes the virus as something to attack and is expected to protect a person from the virus. So this slide shows in detail how does this therapy work. Those who want can pause and read. Next is regarding the World Homeopathy Day. World Homeopathy Day is observed globally on 10th April every year to mark the birth anniversary of the founder of homeopathy, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. The theme of World Homeopathy Day 2020 is linking research with education and clinical practice, advancing scientific collaborations. Next is regarding the Bharat Pade online campaign by Ministry of Human Resource and Development. What happens under this campaign? It involves crowdsourcing of ideas in order to improve the online education ecosystem in India. So we had discussed about the Samadhan campaign of Ministry of Human Resources earlier, right? This campaign is also similar, asking the people to contribute their own ideas into this project. Next is regarding the National Safe Motherhood Day. It is observed annually on 11th April. It is an initiative of the White Ribbon Alliance India, or WRAI, to enforce that women must have the availability and adequate access to care during pregnancy, childbirth, and postnatal services. And India is the first country in the world to have socially declared a National Safe Motherhood Day. Next is regarding the National Tiger Conservation Authority, or NTCA. The National Tiger Conservation Authority is a statutory body, which means it was established by a specific act of government, in this case the Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, which is under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. It was established to coordinate the efforts of the government in conserving tiger population. The slide also talks about Project Tiger. So what is Project Tiger? It is a centrally sponsored scheme of the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, providing funding support to tiger range states for in-situ conservation of tigers in designated tiger reserves. In-situ conservation means protecting the tigers in their own natural habitats, that is in the wild. And Project Tiger has become a success as the statistics of All India Tiger Estimation shows. The next news item is regarding the famous Rafale jets. It says that due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the arrival of the first batch of Rafale fighter jets for the Indian Air Force is likely to be delayed by around 3 months. What of Rafale jets? Rafale is a twin-engine, multi-role combat aircraft designed and built by a French defense company called Dassault Aviation. The aircraft is considered one of the most potent combat jets globally. India is purchasing 36 Rafales from Dassault to strengthen its air force. Next, in FIFA's latest ranking, India retained its 108th rank, while Belgium grabbed the first rank. Champions of the last World Cup, France, is in the second place and Brazil is at the third spot. Also, in the wake of the coronavirus epidemic, the qualifier tournaments have been postponed for the FIFA World Cup and other major games at the international level. The next is regarding yet another online initiative by the Ministry of Human Resources and Development called Yukti, or Young India Combating COVID with Knowledge, Technology and Innovation. It plans to cover different dimensions of COVID-19 challenge in a comprehensive and holistic way. The final news item of the day is about International Day of Human Spaceflight and is observed globally on 12th April. It is actually the anniversary of the first human spaceflight by Yuri Gagarin, which happened on April 12, 1961. The UN General Assembly passed a resolution on April 7, 2011 and had declared April 12 to be celebrated as International Day of Human Spaceflight. So we are now presenting before you NewsUp, an exciting quiz competition based on daily news. The quiz presents before you an opportunity to win exciting prizes along with reading your daily newspaper. All you have to do is to go to Race to IAS website and register your name there. Any student studying in standard 6 to 12 can participate in the program. And the duration of the quiz will be 5 minutes between 8 to 9 p.m. from Monday to Friday. There will be no quiz on Saturday and Sunday. So all of you, go to Race to IAS website now itself and register your names and participate in the quiz program. And in this way, you can make this lockdown periods much more fun and productive. So that's all for this week, guys. Don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe buttons if you haven't already. You can also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok and Hello to get our regular updates. The links are provided in the description box below. Also, download our Junior IAS app from Play Store for daily current affairs, mock tests and quizzes. We will meet again next week. Until then, stay safe guys. Goodbye.